The woman would never have imagined that the man who accompanied her to eat roadside snacks was a dominant president with a billion-dollar fortune. He started with nothing, and with his amazing talent, he made his company become the dominant one in the industry. He is admired by countless rich girls, but few have ever seen his real face. But how could he have imagined that the story of a domineering president falling in love with a Cinderella would happen to him? A few days ago, Annie lied that she was in a relationship with the President Carl in order to keep her hard life going. All her colleagues were envious of her, and the boss even served her tea personally. The story soon made the major newspapers, and Carl was so angry that he immediately called a convoy to set out to meet the unashamed woman today. On the way, he noticed a group of disabled girls blocked by the sewer. Just then, a sweet-looking girl passed by. She quickly figured out a way. Carl slowly rolled down the window, quietly admiring the woman's every move. Usually cold as ice face, could not help but hook up a smile. The company's main business is to provide a wide range of products and services to its customers.
Excuse me.
Annie treated him like a small employee who came to hear gossip, and she took the trouble to tell him her and Carl's love story again. She said it was actually Kai who fell in love with her at first sight and stalked her every day.
कचर 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 और मैं भी सुनती रही फिर एकदम से बोला आई लव यू मुझसे शादी करोगी मैंने बोला बच्चू शादी ब्याह की बातें हवा में थोड़ी तय की जाती है मैंने बोला नो उसने बोला प्लीज मैंने बोला नो उसने बोला प्लीज मैंने बोला ओके बस इतनी सी बात थी
After saying that, Annie sized up Carl, said he must be here for a modeling interview, and casually threw the comb at him and told him to try to speak a commercial. When did the president ever do such a thing? And quietly looked at his man not far away, who was at a loss for words with the comb. Annie saw the man so shy. Some helplessly said to leave contact information. There is work up to you call. Carl not only did not get angry, but also obediently left his phone number. Carl has not left. Annie picked up the phone again, self-conscious about their own and the big president of the love story. Looking at this lovely girl, Carl showed a helpless smile. This president was being interviewed by foreign media when Annie suddenly called and said that there was now a lingerie commercial and asked him to hurry up and come to the audition. How could the president go for a lingerie commercial? In order to keep a low profile, he took a small tricycle for the first time. She gave Carl a raw and emotional introduction to the job, but said Annie suddenly ran away. She saw a blind grandfather in need of help, and patiently explained to him various anecdotes on the roadside on the way, all of which made Carl's heart flutter for her, and the way she smiled and came, more than anything else, made Carl swoon. The next time, the two ate roadside stalls together, went grocery shopping together, visited orphans together, and went to drink weird coffee together. That weird pose stunned the company crowd, and Carl walked into Annie's world little by little, and also unknowingly, completely fell in love with this kind girl. The boss calls Annie to his office, saying that the company will hold a grand party and has already announced to the outside world that the President Carl will be there as promised. So Annie must invite him to the party. Annie was dumbfounded. Where did she know any billionaire president? Wouldn't it be all over now? No one has met him? That's much better. Annie thought about it day and night, and finally came up with a good idea. She hired an actor to pretend to be Carl, but he couldn't play the overbearing president's aura, just in time for Carl to arrive. Carl looked around, and deliberately asked where the hell Carl was.
Sachin, meet Mr. Sanjay.
Yeah.
Annie hits the actor and complains that he can't act, and then confesses everything to Carl. She says it's all her vanity at work and hopes you can help me get through it tonight. Annie suddenly realized that Carl was handsome, noble, and with sunglasses on he was even more aloof and lonely. He was simply the perfect person to impersonate Carl. After she begged, Carl agreed. When Carl arrived in his private custom-made suit, in a multi-million dollar luxury car. Annie's heart was breaking. How much does it cost to rent all this equipment for a day? And he had to pay for it anyway. The man became the focus of the whole scene as soon as he appeared. He behaved dashingly. His demeanor was natural. What made Annie more unexpected was that he actually kissed her in public. Annie instantly blushed. When the orphanage came to Carl for a donation, Annie was trying to get by, but Carl casually took out a check and signed it for $500,000. On the way back, Annie laughed out loud at the big bosses who were usually so high and mighty. But she and Carl had played a trick on them. But suddenly, Carl said with deep emotion,
"I love you."
"What?
I love you. I want to marry you."
Annie said she wasn't ready and would get back to him tomorrow. Carl decided to confess everything if she said yes, and if he was rejected, then he would withdraw from her life as a poor man. Early in the morning, the two meet on the beach and Annie says shyly, Carl is about to confess his identity when Annie suddenly says that if he wants to marry her, he must wait until she owns three cars. Carl knows that Annie has a strong sense of pride, and if he confesses at this point, Annie will find a way to become even richer before agreeing to marry. Carl throws his men an apartment key and asks her to give the house to Annie in a lottery. On the other hand, Annie has sold all her jewelry and bought her first car. She is trying to plan a bright future for the two of them, and is so happy to learn that she has won a big apartment in the lottery that she immediately invites Carl to come and see it. The two of them step down together at the door, hoping that the rest of their lives will go hand in hand. Carl has to go abroad on business for 10 days. He lies to Annie that his mother in the countryside is sick and he has to go back to take care of her. And he even has to sell his land in order to pay for the medical expenses. Annie is worried to hear that and asks him to come back tomorrow night at 10 o'clock. Carl arrived as promised.
Ye kya?
Isme 1,35,000
hai. Tumhari maa ke ilaaj ke.
अपनी कार बेचते
हैं। क्या? क्यों?
कार फिर ले लेंगे।
This money is nothing to Carl, but it contains a strong sense of affection. But he did not know that a sudden calamity is slowly approaching Annie.